सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरंपरां ओं पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ओम शांति शांति शांति। ओम नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंश ऋषिभ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः। सो वी वर लुकिंग एट द 11th वाक्य इन द फोर्थ ब्राह्मण ऑफ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर। हियर द वर्ण सृष्टि इज बीइंग डिस्कस्ड बाय द उपनिषद ओनली टू शो दैट दोस हू डू कर्म based on varna and ashrama for them all this whatever they are qualified to do is all only in this avidya avastha. Okay, those who do not know themselves and those who identify themselves with different varna and ashrama, they are the ones who are qualified to do any karma. Really, to show that only the Upanishad is actually talking about all these different varna srishti, the creation of all these varnas, and this is being done after talking about this avidya sutra. Okay, so the one who does upasana of a devata thinking that the devata is other than me and I am other than that devata, and like that they are doing some worship to gain something, let us say they really do not know this Brahman. Like this, the Avidya Sutram was already talked about. So after that, since this all the Varna Srishti is being talked about, that is only to show that only the Avidvan, the one who has ignorance, one who does not know the reality about oneself, only that person has all this identity with reference to Varna and Ashrama. So varna means you can say there is a certain disposition for everybody to do things in a certain way, and there is a mental disposition also is there. Some people are highly active, some people want to be calm, quiet, studious. Okay, so nowadays we call nerds and all that, correct? There are nerd people are there. There are people who are highly social. And there are people who are social on social media, but not in real life. Like that, there are many groups of people are there. So here, broadly in our tradition and even in the Veda, this Chaturvarna is talked about, four different types of people. So in this, initially the Agni was created, which is the Brahmana Jati. Even amongst Devatas, the Upanishad is saying Agni is a Brahmana Jati Devata. Agni Srishti alone was initially talked about. Sorry. And now the Srishti of other Devatas who are all Kshatriya Devatas, like Indra, Varuna, Somaha, whole host of Devatas are talked about here as Kshatriya Devatas. So these Kshatriya Devatas, the creation not only of the Kshatriya Devatas is being talked about, but also a reference to the Rajasuya Yajna is given here, and it is said that during that Rajasuya Yajna, the king occupies a higher position even than the Brahmana who is actually instructing the king how to do this particular Yajna, okay, this ritual, this fire ritual. And also it involves certain sacrifices and all that. Okay. So, here we saw last week that even Bhashyakara says this Pururava Prabhritini Srishtyani Eva Drashtavyani. That means not only the creation of the Kshatriya Devatas, but even Kshatriyas amongst the Manavas, the human beings who are there now, because they are predominantly of two lineages, you can say Surya Vamsha, Chandra Vamsha, like that. The Surya Vamsha kings are all like Rama is supposed to be Surya Vamsha. Then the Chandra Vamsha kings, the first one is Pururavas. Okay, the Pururava story is an interesting story. You can go and refer even other ways and try to read his story. And here, so further, we were here, I think, Yasmat Brahmana Atishayena Srishtam Chatram. So by this, Brahmana means by this Brahma or Brahmana Jati Abhimana Virat, we have to take, okay? The Prajapati or the Virat, who has the Abhimana that I am a Brahmana. So that is why, in fact, here only Bhashyakara said, correct? Brahmana Jati Abhimana Brahma Iti Abhidiyate. So this Brahma who has this identification that I am a Brahmana, this Virat, has created specially this Kshatriyas. Therefore, what? Tasmat Kshatrat Param Nasti. There is nobody who is higher than these Kshatriyas. Brahmana Jate Hai Api Niyantra. Okay, so the Kshatriyas are the ones who even control the Brahmanas. So, Tasmat Brahmanaha Karana Bhuto Bhi. So, therefore, what? Even though the Brahmanas are the source or the Karana for the Kshatriyas, still Kshatriyam Adhastat Vyavastitaha Sanna Uparistitam Upaste. So, even though the Brahmanas are the Karana for the Kshatriyas, still they sit below. Kshatriyam adhastat vyavastita hasan, and whoever is sitting higher than them, uparistitam upaste. So the Brahmanas sit below the Kshatriyas, okay? And where? Qua Rajasuye, in the Rajasuye Yajna. Okay, so in the Rajasuye Yajna, the king sits at a higher pedestal, you can say, and the Brahmana, who is the Guru, Raja Guru, sits below. Okay, and from this, what do we understand? Kshatriyeva tat atmiyam yashaha khyati rupam brahma iti dadhati sthapayati. So, not only that, so by doing this arrangement, one's own fame and glory, the Brahmana, is actually giving one's own fame and glory to the Kshatriya, okay, which is in the form of fame. Khyati rupam yashaha atmiyam means one's own. And how does he give that fame? By calling the Kshatriya as a Brahmana. Okay? That Bhashyakara will explain here. So he says, Rajasuya abhishiktena asandhyam sthitena rajnya amantritaha brahmaniti ritvik punastam pratyaha tvam rajan brahmasiti. So in the Rajasuya yajna, the king is sitting, okay, and then he calls out, okay, amantritaha means invites or calls the Brahmana priest, whoever is supposed to guide him in doing the Rajasuya Yajna. He calls him as Brahman, hey Brahmana, like that, okay, Brahmaniti Ritvik amantritaha. So the Ritvik, who is called like that, who is addressed as hey Brahman, hey Brahmana, like that. Then to him, to that king, this Brahmana, what does he say? He says, Tvam Rajan Brahmasi. Hey Raja, you are the Brahmana. Like that he says. So as part of that ritual, it is like that. Okay. So when the Raja is addressed as a Brahmana here, no, that's what the Shruti is referring to, Bhashyakara says. So what actually that means is the Kshatriya is getting all the glory, okay? Even the Brahmana's glory is Kshatriya's here. So tad etad abhidhiyate. So this is only being denoted by the Shruti, because Shruti here, it says Kshatra eva tad yashaha dadhati, like that, correct? So when it says this, what is the Shruti referring to? It is referring to this conversation which happens as part of that Rajasuya Yajna, okay? That's what the Shruti is saying. Saisha Kshatrasya Yoni Yad Brahma. So that part now we are going. Saisha Prakrita. So Saisha means here whoever, that or this Kshatriyas about whom we are discussing, Prakrita. yonihi eva yat brahma. So the source of the kshatriya is really the brahmanas only, because only the initially only the brahmana devata agni was there from, and after that only all this kshatriya devatas and kshatriyas were created. So even though the brahmana is the yoni, is the source of the kshatriya, so tasmad yadyapi raja paramatam rajasuya abhishek gunam gacchati apnoti brahmaiva brahmana jati meva antataha ante karma parisamaptau upanishrayati ashrayati swam yonim purohitam puronidatta ityarthah. So here saisha kshatrasya yonihi yad brahma tasmad yadyapi raja paramatam gacchati brahmaiva antataha upanishrayati swam yonim, like this. This part Bhashyakara is explaining here. So what Bhashyakara is saying, even though during the Rajasuya Yajna, the Raja is becoming exalted, we can say, okay. So he is being anointed, we can say, to use an English word, because we don't know what other word we can use. Abhisheka and all is actually our cultural word, correct? Our cultural concept. I don't know whether we can really call it anointing and all that, but anointing is something similar, you can say, in English if we want to use. So the whoever is the Raja who has been done this Abhisheka during the Rajasuya Yajna, and because of which he is gained a certain exalted status, let us say. But even after this Rajasuya is over, correct, or at the end of this Rajasuya, karma parisamaptau, at the end of all this Yajna, this Kshatriya again what takes refuge in the Brahmana only, Upanishrayati, Ashrayati, okay, Swam Yonim, because the Brahmana is the source of the Kshatriya. And how does he do? Purohitam Puraha Nidatta Ityarthaha. So the Purohita means what? The one who stands in front. So the Brahmana again stands in front of the Kshatriya. Okay. Like that. Therefore, again the Brahmana is considered to be exalted, you can say, having an exalted status. After this Rajasuya, or at the end of the Rajasuya, again it is like this. Because the Brahmana is the source of the Kshatriya. Now, further what? Yastu punaha bala abhimanat. Okay, so, but let us say Kshatriya thinks that I am very strong. I am the strongest. Okay. Like that, if he has an abhimana, a thinking, then what can happen? He can become a dictator, correct? So, anybody who has power, if they are not guided by dharma, they can become cruel. They can become dictators, correct? So that's what. So if some kshatriya becomes like this, he is drunk with power and has no responsibility, correct? With great power comes great responsibility. Like that, there is a movie dialogue which is very famous, which is true, I think. It's a good dialogue. I like it, actually. So if a kshatriya becomes irresponsible, means what? Basically not guided by any values. He just wants to do whatever he wants. Okay. Guided by his own likes and dislikes, and has a lot of power also, means that is a problem. Then what? That kshatriya can. So swam yonim brahmana jatim brahmanam yavu enam hinasti himsati. So the kshatriya can become violent against the Brahmana also, correct? Can do himsa, can harm, hurt, all that. Nyakbhavena pashyati swam atmiyam eva sa yoni mrichati swam prasavam vichinnati vinashayati. So basically what he looks upon the Brahmana with not the right attitude, okay? And also then one's own yoni or the or the source, you can say again, or the womb, he destroys. Okay, if he does anything against the Brahmana, it is like the Kshatriya is destroying his own womb. And if he does like that, what happens? Sa etat kritva papiyan papataraha bhavati. So the one, the Kshatriya who does like this, who does himsa towards the Brahmanas, who becomes a dictator, who is not guided by any dharma, means he becomes a papi. He is accumulating only papa. And Puruvamapi Kshatriyaha Papa Eva Kruratva. So anyway, the Kshatriya karma is Kruram only, Bhashyakara says. Why? Because if you are in the army or police and all that, let us say, your work is not non-violent. Okay, you cannot say, I am a follower of Gandhi, I will show my other cheek if some criminal is slapping me, I'll show the other cheek. Can you say that? You cannot, correct? You are not there for that. In fact, your duty is to protect the people even with the use of force. So any Kshatriya has to use force. Violence is inevitable in their job. So already it is a cruel job in one way, because violence is anyway involved. But in this case, what if they are going against and doing violence against the Brahmanas or the intellectual class, let us say, Atma Prasava Himsaya. Okay, so if they are doing Himsa against their own source, okay, own womb, Sutaram, it is even more cruel, you can say. So Yatha Loke, so similarly, like even in the Loka, Shreyansam Prashasta Taram Himsitva Paribhuya Papataraha Bhavati. So if you are doing himsa to your own superiors, that is looked upon as very, it's not a proper behavior, correct? It is papa. Like that here also, it is like that. So a Kshatriya should not become a dictator and go against the intellectuals, the ones who are the Brahmanas essentially. Okay, here the Brahmana Varna, the Brahmanas, again, they do not have the power with the Kshatriyas have, but they are the ones, guardians of all the knowledge. They are the teachers, and they are the ones who are praying for others. So there are certain karma only the Brahmanas are doing, and that has to be respected. So if knowledge is not respected in a society, then in fact that whole society is going to suffer. So that's why all these things are said here. Okay, now the other devatas of other varnas are also, now Upanishad is going to talk. Okay, so even after Brahmanas and Kshatriyas were created, okay, so sanaiva vyabhavat, even after that, there was no flourishing, the society was not flourishing. Okay, why? Therefore, what? Sa visham asrijat, visham here means vaishya, that's what, wit, visham and all is for vaishyas. So visham asrijat means they created this virat in the form of rhino, in the form of brahmanas and kshatriyas, also created vaishya jati. Yani etani deva jatani ganashaha akhyayante. So all these Vaishya Devatas, they are all counted in groups. Okay. Why? Because, so all the Devatas who are in groups are all Vaishya Devatas, like this Upanishad is saying. Why? Bhashyakara gives an interesting reason here that we will see. But here, all the Devatas who are in groups, like what? Vasavaha. So Ashta Vasu we say, correct? There are eight Vasus are there. The Vasu Devatas are eight in number. So Vasavaha, Rudraha, and Rudras are there. Ekadasha Rudraha, there are 11 Rudras. Adityaha, again. So Adityas are 12 in number. Dvadasha Adityas are there. Then Vishve Devaha means generally all other Devatas whom you have not enumerated explicitly, they are all called Vishve Devaha. Or here Bhashyakara also gives another meaning, that there are 13 Vishve Devas, who are all children of a devata called Vishwa. And then Marutaha, Marut, 49 Maruts are there, like that. So all these group devatas are all Vaishya devatas. Okay, all these Vaishya devatas were created, like this Upanishad says. So Bhashyakara here, Kshatre Srishtepi sa naiva vyabhavat. So even after creating of this Kshatra, creation of the Kshatriyas, the society in general did not flourish. Okay, or the Virat did not flourish. Why? Karmane Brahma Tathana Vyabhavat. So in whatever the Brahmanas and the Kshatriyas wanted to do, in that they did not flourish. Whatever they have to do, Kartavyam is there, correct? Is to be done by them. In that they did not flourish. Why? Because Vitta Uparjayituhu Abhava. So they did not have anybody who is a wealth creator. So wealth creation is very important. See, none of these Varnas we should look down upon. Just only the Brahmanas and Kshatriyas are not good enough. Correct? You need wealth creators. Those who create wealth only, their surplus only they are giving to others. In the form of tax, they are giving it to the Kshatriyas. In the form of Dakshina and donation and all that, they are giving it to the Brahmanas. So the wealth creators are very, very important. So because wealth creators are not there, these other two are not flourishing. So therefore what? Sa visham asrijata karma sadhana vitto uparjanaya. So they created this Vaishyas so that the karma sadhana vittaha means what? To do karma. See, that's what. So our tradition did not look down upon wealth or anything. Wealth creators are always welcomed, okay, are always looked upon as with a great status, because they are the ones who are the means to do all this Vaidika karma. How are you going to do all the karma? Karma sadhana is only vitta, wealth. Without wealth, you cannot do anything. And who will give you wealth? Unless there are wealth creators are there and they are ready to share their surplus with you, you cannot do any Vaidika karma. You cannot also have any kingdom to rule if nobody is paying you tax. So, therefore, to gain wealth, which is the means to do all this karma, which is to be done by both Kshatriyas and Brahmanas, they created the Vaishyas. So, and who are these Vaishyas? Kaha punaha aso vit. So, vit, wish only becomes vit at the end of the word. And visham is the dvitiya. Okay. So who is this? Who are these Vaishyas, or who is this Vaishya? Vit. Yani etani devajatani. Okay. Swarthe nishta sa yete devajati bhedaha ityarthaha. Okay. So yani etani devajatani. So who are all these devajatis who are involved, or whatever you can say, nishtha means committed, who are committed to artha, okay, wealth. And they are ye ete devajati bedaha iti arthaha. So those who are this in the devajati, okay, they have this difference, what they are established in their own or in creating wealth, and they are again different in which way, okay, let us see, because they are counted in numbers, in groups. So ganashaha ganam ganam akhyayante kathyante. So those who are different from other devatas, okay, in the, because they are counted in groups, that is the whole idea here. And who are the ganaprayahi vishaha? So amongst the devatas, whoever is different and whoever is counted in groups, they are the Vaishyas amongst the devatas. Why? Because Bhashyakara here gives the reason. Prayena samhatahi vittopargane samarthaha na ekaika shaha. So here Bhashyakara says, even in this world, generally, if you want to earn wealth, okay, you have to be in groups, it seems. So in those days, I think even merchants and all, they used to travel in groups. Traders, merchants, or even if you are doing any work, let us say even agriculture, you cannot do it by yourself. You have to do it in groups only. So here, that's why this wealth creation requires you to work in a group. You cannot do it by yourself. Na ekaika shaha, by being alone, by being one man, you cannot do anything. You cannot earn enough wealth. Therefore, they do it in groups. So like even here, the Vaishyas are creating wealth by being in groups. Similarly, all the Devatas who are in groups, they are all considered to be Vaishya Devatas. So Vasavaha, Ashtasankhyaha, Ganaha. So the Vasus are 8 in number. Yeah, Ashtasankhyaha. Tatha Ekadasha Rudraha. Similarly, there are 11 Rudras are there. Then Dvadasha Adityaha, 12 Adityas are there. Then Vishve Devaha, Trayodashaha. So there are 13 Vishve Devas who are all Vishvayaha Apatyani. So who are the Apatyam means son or daughter. Okay. So one who is issue. Sometimes in English they use the word issue, correct? Literally, it means that only. Apatyam means one who has issued out of you. So does he have any issues like that? Sometimes people ask. Issue there is not a problem. Or in one way, children are a problem means you can call them issue also. But the English word issue is interestingly used in the meaning of children, which is, I think, very close to the word apatyam, really. Or offspring, you can say. Apatyam means also can be called offspring. Offspring word also somewhat very near to. Path means to fall down. Correct? The path dhatu. So one who has sprung from you also can be called apatyam, I think. So anyway, trayodasha vishvayaha apatyani. So these 13 Vishve Devas are all offsprings of this Vishwa, there is a Devata, or Sarveva Deva, all Devatas who are not otherwise specifically mentioned, they are all generally called Vishve Devaha, all other Devatas. That is also a, traditionally, that's how, in fact, even I understand that. So, Marutaha, Sapta Sapta Ganaha, and then Marut, they are groups of seven. Like that, seven groups are there. So totally 49 Marut Devatas are also there. So all these Devatas are all Vaishya Devatas. So they were created. Therefore, wealth can be created for doing all this karma. Whatever is to be done for that purpose, wealth is required. For that, this Vaishya Devatas were created. Then what? Even then, they did not flourish because there was nobody else to do the other work. So, sa naiva vyabhavate, therefore what? Sa shaudram varnam asrijata. So then what? The shudras were also created. And shudras are the ones who nourish the others by serving them. Okay. So, that's what this Upanishad is saying. Pushanam yam vai pusha yam hi idam sarvam pushyati yadidam kincha. So, this pusha, Devata. Pushan is a Devata. And who is this Pushan? Shruti itself says, Yam Prithivi, this Prithivi, this earth alone is called Pushan Devata because it is the one which nourishes everybody. So, Bhashyakara here, Saha Paricharaka Abhavat. So, Paricharaka means serving others. And because there was nobody to serve these people and do all the work, still they did not flourish. So only Brahmana, Kshatriya and Vaishya alone cannot do anything. There has to be people who has to work, correct? those who are ready to serve others. So in this, all these things somehow nowadays are looked upon as some kind of a, just because we say that there are people who are ready to serve others, that doesn't mean we demean them or anything. See, some people, if you take, in fact, majority of the people, if you take a survey now, they will all be ready to serve others and have a cushy job, correct? Government job and all is highly coveted. So instead of putting risk and starting a business and creating wealth and all, it's not for everybody, correct? In fact, 95% of the people will be ready to serve, I think. So just saying that a group of people, the Shudras, are there to serve others does not mean that we are really demeaning them or anything. In fact, really speaking, most people would like to serve others and have an easy life, correct? Whatever, you have regular income, so you don't have too much risk in your life. But others' life is not like that. A soldier's life is highly risky, correct? How many people are, even though India we have voluntary army, but not everybody joins the army or wants to even become an army man, correct? Going and sitting somewhere in Siachen and guarding in the Himalayas, the border and all, is not easy work. But some people have the, let me say, the disposition, inclination to do that. They are Kshatriyas, really, correct? Like that, many people want to only serve others and just live their life, enjoy whatever security they have. So they are all Shudras only, really. But nothing wrong in being that. There are different classes or different types of people. So the society is made up of all these four types of people, and all of them are required for the society to flourish. So that's what is coming out here. The Upanishad is also telling that. So because there was nobody to serve, punaha api naiva vyabhavate. So again still there is, all these people did not flourish. So what? Saha shaudram varnam asrijata. So the Shudras were now created. And again, Shaudram, the word, really, Shudra eva Shaudraha, this is called Taddita Pratyaya. So, Taddita Pratyaya, when it comes, the first vowel will become Vriddhi, it is called in Sanskrita terminology, Vyakarana terminology. The Shu becomes Shau, correct? So, Shu becoming Shau is called Vriddhi. Au, U becoming Au is called Vriddhi, really. So this vriddhi happens because the anpratyaya comes, tadita pratyaya. Ani vriddhi, like that Bhashikara is giving, swarthe. So the anpratyaya actually can come in many meanings. One, here it has come in the swartha, means in the same meaning. There is no difference in the meaning. For example, this South Indians are supposed to use lot of tadita, like that there is a saying. So the dakshinatyaha tadita priyaha, like that there is a saying. Those who are from the Dakshina, from South, are all very fond of using Tadita, it seems. So, in fact, even in South Indian languages, we don't say Sukha. Saukhya we say. In fact, both are having same meaning only. So, the Shen also is a Tadita Pratyaya. The Su becomes Sau, then the Ya comes there. Okay, Saukhya, Sukha becomes Saukhya. Saukhya Ma, like that we ask, in fact. So, are you feeling good? Are you enjoying yourself? Saukhya ma. So, Sukha becomes Saukhya, like that. In South, we have a lot of Tadita usage. So, here the Shudra became Shaudra. But An can come in other meanings also, understand. In fact, Tasya Apatyam, like that, there is a Sutra is there in Panini. And even like it can come in the meaning of sun. So, you can add An. So, Anjana. Okay, or Raghu is there, and the one who has come in the Kula of Raghu will call Raghava because you added the An. Correct? Kuru, Kaurava, this is all An only. So, An can come in the form of a descendant, in the meaning of descendant or immediate son also. Pritha, Pritha's son becomes Partha. Correct? Partha is Arjuna. Or in fact, Partha can be really used for any of the Pandavas. Because Pritha is the name of Kunti. okay, and Kunti's son is Partha, but here Partha and Partha Sarathi in specific is only Krishna, and Partha is used for Arjuna. But technically speaking, the etymologically, if you see Partha, any son of Pritha is a Partha. Okay. So, like that, this anpratyaya, here it is come in the swartha, means in the same meaning. There is no real difference in the meaning. Swarthe and ani vriddhihi. So the shudra becomes shaudraha. Okay. Kaha punaha asau shaudraha varnaha yaha srishtaha. So who is the one who was created with this shudra varna? Means pushanam. Pushyati iti pusha. So who was created? This pushan devata was created. And why that devata is called pushan? Means the one who nourishes. Pushyati iti pusha. Okay, pushan. The prathama ekavachanam becomes pusha, but the dvitiya becomes pushanam. You can see there. This is all grammar point thing, but anyway, it occurs to be. So here kaha punaha so pusha iti visheshataha tan nirdishati. So who is this pusha? You have given a name and you are saying the one who nourishes is pusha, but who is this? That Shruti itself is specifically now indicating, because the word pusha does not directly mean prithvi. So, but here it says, okay, so yam hi idam sarvam pushyati yadidam kincha, like that. So yam prithvi, this prithvi, this earth is the pusha. Swayameva nirvachanam aha yam hi idam sarvam pushyati yadidam kincha. So this prithvi is the pusha devata, Pushan Devata, otherwise, because Prithivi is the one who nourishes all of us. This earth is the one who nourishes all of us. Okay. So all these four Varnas are created. So what? Even then they did not flourish. All types of people are there. But unless they have a matrix of values, and there is a certain order, moral order is there, the society will be not flourishing. Otherwise, there will be only disorder. Might is right. All that. Anarchy will be there. Correct? So, that is now coming here, interestingly. So, it says, sa naiva vyabhavat. Even now, they did not flourish. Why? Tat shreyo rupam atya srijata. So, okay. They are not still flourishing. So, they again created a special some form, okay, rupa. What is that? Dharmam. So dharma itself is created, this order. And again dharma as given in the Veda, okay, shastras. So if you conduct yourself as given in the shastras and not according to your likes and dislikes, because most of the problems are coming only because you want to do as per your own likes and dislikes, then you disregard others, whatever others right and whatever others expectation, because you have a certain expectation from all others and they also have similar expectation from you. You do not want anybody to hurt you. They also do not want anybody to hurt them. They expect the same from you. Are you ready to then keep that as a common matrix of values and behave accordingly? You can. But sometimes what? Your likes and dislikes are pressuring you. So the one who goes along with his likes and dislikes is a asura. Like this we already saw in the third brahmana and all. Who is an asura? The one, if your indriyas go with their natural tendency towards their indriya artha, correct? The objects, the senses go after the sense objects without any regards for dharma, what is right and wrong, then that senses themselves become asuras. But if the same senses, instead of going with its natural inclination and tendency, but acts as per the whatever is said in the Shastra, acts righteously, acts according to Dharma, then that becomes a Deva. Like this Deva Asura that we already saw, but even here it is relevant. So that's why all these Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, they are all there. But if they only go by their likes and dislikes, then there won't be any order. It will be like roads in India, but somehow in India, roads still are, even though they are chaotic, it is still functioning. I don't know how. But everybody wants to go everywhere. But you require, even in India, okay, people still stop at some signals and all that, correct? Otherwise, there will not be any order. So this dharma is that regulation. It is the one which regulates even the kshatriyas. Because kshatriyas, power-wise, they are the most powerful, correct? If there is nobody to regulate the kshatriyas, then they can usurp the power and become dictators and do anything they want. Means, then there won't be any order. So that's why, even after all this creating all these different varnas, dharma specially was created, like this Upanishad is saying beautifully. And this dharma, see, tad etat kshatrasya kshatram. So what is this dharma? It is even the kshatriya to the kshatriya, or the one who controls the kshatriya also. Okay? He is the one who regulates even the kshatriya. The dharma is the one which has to regulate even the kshatriya, who is the most powerful amongst all these varnas. And yet dharma tasmat dharmat param nasti. So this dharma is the one which regulates even the kshatriyas. Therefore, there is nothing higher than this dharma. And why we say that? Yathaha abaliyan baliyan samashamsate dharmena yatha rajnya evam yo vai sa dharmaha satyam vai tat tasmat satyam vadan vadantam ahuhu dharmam dharmam vadati iti dharmam va vadantam satyam vadati ityetad kheva etad ubhayam bhavati. Okay, so here this part is one part. Okay, see, this dharma, there is nothing greater than dharma. Okay, dharmat param nasti. Then what? Yataha. Why? Because it is giving one situation or whatever analogy here. Abaliyan baliyan shamasam sate dharmena. So even the one who is not having bala, who is weak, who doesn't have strength, can take on the stronger one if he feels that he is right. Okay. So dharma is on my side means even as a weaker person, I can take on the stronger one and I think I will win. I have this somehow this because I have this conviction, this force within me, which says that I can even take on physically somebody stronger, but I am right. Okay, the other person is really wrong. Since I am right, I have this strength within me to even take on. I think I can still win, taking over or taking on a stronger person. Even though I am weaker, I am ready to take on the stronger person and even think I can win against him. Okay. So that is the strength of dharma. So Upanishad is saying that. Therefore, dharma is even greater than kshatriyas. So even you can take on even the raja. That's what. Even an ordinary citizen can confront the king. And there were kings like that in India. We have so many stories, correct? Even that Manunidhi Cholan, like that we have. Even in Tamil Nadu, there was a king called Manunidhi. Okay, and what happens? The king's son goes in a chariot and makes an accident, let us say. Or he deliberately ran his chariot over a calf. Okay. And the calf died. Then the cow goes to the king and asks for justice. like this, there are stories are there. So the king has to answer, okay, whatever is right. King cannot give a different verdict because his son is involved in that. Like this, there are many stories in our sacred lore. But even kings have to go by what is dharma, even if it is against themselves or their family and all that. So even a weaker person can take on the stronger one. Normal family person can go and take on the king who is supposed to have all the power, correct? Because you are on the side of the right. Okay, or righteousness, that is very important. And then Upanishad is saying something interesting. It is saying, Yo vai saha dharmaha satyam vai tat. So whatever we say is dharma, is satyam. Now what do we mean by satyam here? Okay. So satyam means truth, you can say. But here what Bhashyakara says, yatha shastrarthata. Like this, he is giving satyam iti. So whatever is said in the shastra, okay, what is dharma, or whatever we understand as dharma, is nothing but whatever is said in the shastra. That is what is said here as satyam. So whatever is dharma is really whatever is said in the shastras, in the Veda, in the different shastras. And therefore what? And then it even says something very interesting here. So tasma satyam vadantam ahuhu dharmam vadati. So the one who is saying whatever is said in the shastra, correct? For that person, people say that he's actually telling dharma. So actually he is telling about whatever is said in the shastra with reference to, let us say, somebody's behavior or how one should do something, etc., or what is right or what is wrong. But then when somebody is talking about whatever is said in the shastra as the right conduct, we actually say that he is talking dharma. Okay, like that it is said, it seems. So dharmam vadati iti. Similarly, dharmam va vadantam satyam vadati iti. So, or if somebody is talking about whatever is right conduct in a particular situation as per accepted norms and all that, then also we are saying that he is actually only talking whatever is there in the shastra. Like that, we interchangeably, it is being talked about satyam vadati iti. So therefore, why? Because it yetad yeva yetad ubhayam bhavati. Because these two are not separate really. Okay. Satyam, whatever is said in the shastra alone is dharma or right conduct, and whatever is right conduct is nothing but whatever is said in the shastra. So like this, the Upanishad is talking here. Let us quickly see the Bhashya. So Bhashyakara says, Saha chaturaha srashtva api varnan naiva vyabhavat. So even after creating the fourth varna, they did not flourish. Why? Ugratvat. So the kshatriyasya ugratvat, he says. So the kshatriyas are very aggressive. Ugra means you can say cruel or aggressive, like that. Why? Because they do not have anybody to regulate them. Aniyata shankaya. Okay, aniyata ashankaya. So they do not have anybody to regulate them. So there is a fear that the kshatriyas will go berserk if there is nobody to regulate them. That ashanka is there. Therefore what? Tat shreyo rupam atyasrijyata. So therefore something special was again created. What? Kim tat dharmam. Dharma was created. Tad etat shreyo rupam srishtam kshatrasya kshatram. So whatever was specially created, that is the regulator of even the kshatriya. Kshatrasya kshatram. Kshatrasya api niyantra. Niyantra means one who controls or regulates. regulator. So everywhere regulators are required, correct? Even in modern societies, you have a regulator for everything. There is a stock market, means there is a regulator for that. And if you have all companies, then even there is a monopoly, should not be there. So there are regulators in every country. Names may be different. Then if you have a telecom industry, there is a regulator. Insurance industry has a regulator. In fact, each industry wise, there are regulators are there. So everywhere regulation is required. So this dharma is the regulator of even the kshatriyas. Ugradapi ugram. Because the consequences of adharma can be very cruel. That's why Bhashyakara is saying ugradapi ugram. So if the kshatriyas can be aggressive and cruel, then they have to face the consequences for that, correct? So that's why this dharma, this moral order, papa punya, these are all very important. Nobody can escape your karma phala. Okay, so you have to be very clear about that. Whatever you do, depending on whether it is right or wrong, you have to enjoy the consequences of that. So yad dharmaha, yaha dharmaha, so yad dharmaha is there here, should be actually Bhashyakara immediately changes it to yaha dharmaha, because dharma is pullinga, so this yad is changing to yaha. Tasmat, therefore what? Kshatrasyapi niyantritva. So because this dharma is even the regulator of kshatriyas, dharmat param nasti, so there is nothing greater than dharma. Why? Because tenahi niyamyante sarve, so everybody is controlled or regulated only by this dharma. And how is that? Tat kathamiti uchyate, how is that it is being said here? Athaha api abaliyan durbalataraha. Okay, baliyam baliyam sam atmanaha balavattaramapi ashamsate kamayate jetum dharmena balena. So Bhashyakara here, so therefore what, thereafter here what, api athaha api, so further why it is being said is because abaliyan, one who is durbala taraha, one who is weak, one who does not have bala, and baliyam sam, the one who is stronger than oneself. Atmanaha balavattaram means one who is stronger than oneself. Okay, even with respect to him, what? Ashamsate means kamayate, he desires for what? To win over him. Jetum kamayate, he thinks that he can take on and win over the stronger person. Why? Only because of the strength of dharma. Dharmena balena. Because I am on the side of dharma. So even the Mahabharata war is like that, correct? If you see purely by the number of troops and all that, the Kauravas, the Duryodhanarashtras, we have to really say, because Kaurava, really even Pandavas are Kauravas. Kuru is the, they are all descendants of Kuru only. But somehow in popular terminology, we are using for, we should say Dhartarashtra. There also tasya apatyam, and Dhritarashtrasya apatyam Dhartarashtraha. So Dhartarashtraha means Dhritarashtrasya apatyani, all the offsprings, issues of Dhritarashtra, more than 100 of them, they are fighting against Pandavas who are only 5. And even the Akshauni, the battle is happening, and all these forces are there, correct? They are all actually measured in a unit called Akshauni. Akshauni is called. So they had more, the Dhartarashtras. But still the Pandavas are taking on them, because they have dharma on their side, that strength, and Bhagavan also is there with them. They chose Bhagavan, correct? So Duryodhana and Arjuna both went to Krishna. And Krishna being Bhagavan made happy, made both of them happy. How? Duryodhana really wanted all the forces of Yadava forces, okay? Because Krishna had already told that either you choose me, but I won't fight, or you take all my forces, army. They will fight for you. Whom do you want? And Krishna is sleeping. And both Duryodhana and Arjuna are waiting. And Duryodhana is desperate to ask for all the forces of Krishna. Okay. And Arjuna also is there. And Krishna wakes up. What does Krishna do? He sees both of them, but he says, since I saw Arjuna first, he has the first right to ask from me whatever he wants. He says like that. So at that time, I think Duryodhana's heart must have stopped. He is desperate. So he does not want Arjuna to take all the forces of Krishna. But Arjuna says, no, no, I want only you. So at that time, I think Duryodhana would have been really happy. This foolish fellow has taken a non-fighting Krishna and given me all these Yadava forces who are all battle-hardened and all that. But at that time, both were happy. Arjuna was happy that he had Krishna on his side. And Duryodhana also was happy. But then, still the Pandavas were able to take on, because in the Dharma Yuddha, on whose side Dharma is very important. Therefore, even a weak person can take on the stronger one if he thinks that he has Dharma on his side. That's what Dharmena Balena, that is the power of this Dharma. Righteousness, like that we can say. So we'll continue this next week. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.
धन्यवाद गुरुजी।